Hello dear students, today we are going to start our chapter number 3, that is morphology of reproductive part, and in that we are going to study what detail about the flower. Okay, in previous lecture we learnt about the inflorescence. What is inflorescence? Inflorescence is nothing but it is the cluster of flower which is born on a specialized axis, that is called as inflorescence. So that in that we learn different types of inflorescence, for example cymose inflorescence, racemose inflorescence. Again we learn different type of special type of inflorescences as well. So in this part or in this lecture we are going to study the flower, its definition, its detailed parts. All parts we are going to cover in this lecture, and what is the significance of the flower. Okay, so let us start by the introduction of this chapter. So basically flowers, before starting to the flower, we'll discuss the life cycle of a plant, which is a angiosperm or any flowering plant if you take. So that life cycle is a cycle. Okay, so basically it starts from one point and it ends to the same point. So if we take a seed, if we start a cycle by taking the seed, so that seed we saw in the soil, the seed will get germinated, it will grow into the seedlings, and after that it starts its vegetative growth, in that it increase in size, number of branches are produced, and then leaves are produced. So stem, leaves and your root, all these parts are called as vegetative part, and the growth of this part is called as vegetative growth. When it attains a proper vegetative growth, again its reproductive growth starts. So what is reproductive growth? Reproductive growth means growth of the reproductive organs. So here, what are the reproductive organs of the plant? So basically that inflorescence that we learnt in earlier lecture, that is a reproductive part. Then this flower inflorescence itself is a group of flower, and the individual member of that inflorescence is a flower. That flower is a reproductive part. So reproductive part, this floral part is a reproductive part. So flower is very important organ from plant perspective. Flower is important for the reproduction of the plant. Without flower, plant cannot reproduce, even though there are different methods of vegetative reproduction also. But in sexual reproduction, where there is a formation of seeds and fruits, that is very much important. That flower is very much important as a part. So that floral or a flower, which is a very important and significant reproductive part, without that all the important processes like your pollination, then your fertilization, formation of seeds, formation of fruits, it takes place in the flower. So flower is very important part. So that is about the introduction. Then we'll discuss what is the definition of the flower. So how the flower is defined? See, flower is defined like it is the highly condensed and modified shoot. See, vegetative growth is present. Vegetative growth means for growth of stems, growth of leaf. So stem is a shoot part. Okay, so in that shoot part, again this shoot arises which bears the flower. So that flower is nothing but it is the highly condensed, it is highly condensed and modified shoot. It is a one kind of a specialized shoot, okay, which is aerial in nature. Okay, so it is the highly condensed and modified shoot of limited growth. It is having limited growth, which is specialized for the sexual reproduction. This point needs to be taken into consideration. So it is why flowers are produced. We see the beauty of flower from our perspective. Flowers are very beautiful, and the purpose of flower is to beautify the plants, that is from our perspective. But from plant's perspective, flower is very much significant or important for the reproduction purpose, for the perpetuation of that species. So if plant has to perpetuate, if it has to continue its generation, it has to produce the flowers, it has to get fertilized, it has to get produce the seeds. Until and unless it happens, the plants cannot perpetuate. So from our point of view, the flower is having the beautification purpose for us. We just see the flower and say, wow, it's a very beautiful flower. So, but from, it is from our perspective, but from plant's perspective, it is a very important reproductive part. So that is about the definition of flower. Then we'll discuss the parts of the flower. We'll discuss the parts of the flower. So basically that flower is having two different parts. First is floral axis. First part is the floral axis, and second part is the floral leaves. Second part is floral leaves. So what is floral axis? Floral axis, it is the axis of the shoot. Okay, so if we see here, if we see in this flower, I have drawn here the flower part of the typical flower. We'll discuss, I have drawn this figure, but if you see here this portion, up to this portion, so this below portion is nothing but it is the floral axis. It is the floral axis. Okay, so it consists of two parts. First one is pedicel and second one is thalamus. Okay, I have written there floral axis, it consists of two parts. It is the pedicel and thalamus. Okay, so here floral axis is nothing but is the axis of the shoot. It is associated with bract. So this point needs to be taken into consideration, that this pedicel sometimes bears a small tiny leaf like structure. That leaf like structure is called as a bract. Here some tiny leaf like structure may present. If the bract is present, flower is called as bracteate. If it is absent, it is called as abracteate. So that pedicel, what is pedicel? It is the stalk of the flower. Okay, it is the stalk of the flower. If the flower, if it is having pedicel or stalk, it is called as pedicellate flower. And if it doesn't have the stalk, then it is called as sessile flower. Okay, so what is the significance of pedicel? It is nothing but the stalk of the flower. It is the stalk. If the stalk is present, it is called as pedicellate flower. If the stalk is absent, then it is called as sessile flower. It is called as sessile flower. So that is about the stalk of the flower. Then second thing is thalamus. Thalamus is again second part of this floral axis. Thalamus, it is, if you see here, it is the swollen leaf, swollen apex of the pedicel. It is present at the tip of the pedicel. Okay, it is present at the tip of the pedicel. It is a swollen part. Okay, so again it is devoid of any floral leaves. Okay, so these two are the parts of the floral axis. Okay, and second is your floral leaves. This is very much important thing, floral leaves. So what are floral leaves? Again, that floral leaves are again divided, or they are of, consist of four different types of floral leaves. First one is calyx, second one is corolla, third one is androecium, and last one is gynoecium. So we have seen here two parts. First, up to this part, it is the floral axis, and above this, all these are floral leaves. All these are floral leaves. Okay, now, so we'll start by one studying all the floral leaves. First is the calyx. Okay, calyx, here you can see, here I have drawn this calyx. So that calyx is the outermost floral leaves. Okay, floral leaves are, or they are also called as floral whorls. They are also called as floral whorls. Floral whorls, or a group of floral leaves is called as floral whorl. Okay, so here it is, this calyx is the outermost part of the outermost floral leaf or floral whorl. Again, it is generally green in color. I have drawn here by blue, but it is green in color. Okay. So, this is the outermost floral whorl. Individual member of this calyx is called as sepal. If you take one this, then it is called as sepal. If you take all these 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, then it becomes calyx. Okay. If it is in group, it is called as calyx. If it is single, then we call it as a sepal. So, what is the significance of this outermost floral whorl, that is calyx? It is generally green in color. Being green in color, it always helps in the photosynthesis. Okay. Second important thing is it protects the inner floral whorl, which are present inside to that floral whorl. For example, next one is your corolla, then androecium, then gynoecium. It protects inner floral whorl. Okay. So these are two important functions which the calyx perform. Second is corolla. Second floral whorl or floral leaves is corolla. So what is corolla? Corolla is the second floral whorl. Individual member of corolla is called as petal. Individual member is called as petal. So this corolla is what will look, or the flower makes flower becomes attractive because of this corolla. Petals, you know petals very well. Petals are of different color, brightly colored petals are there, blue, red, yellow, green. Again, there are different colors of the petals which make that flower attractive, which attracts us towards that flower. But this is that is not meant for our attraction, but for the attraction of the different sorts of insects for the purpose of pollination. That needs to be remembered. So it is the second floral whorl. It is present inside the calyx. Then this is brightly colored. It is always, almost most of the time, it is brightly colored. And why it is brightly colored? It is brightly colored so as to attract the different types of pollinators. For example, different insects, honeybees. Okay, these are pollinators, and that need for the attraction, because there needs to be there is a necessity of pollination. Without pollination, the fertilization cannot take place, pollen grains cannot go there into the gynoecium, in the ovary, and all these things, all this stuff will not happen. So for that, the pollination to occur, what is required? That pollination process should be required, and for the pollination phenomenons, different pollinating agents are required, and this pollination agents will get attracted by this petal. So its individual member is called as petal. It is attractive, it is innermost. See, it is the fourth floral whorl. This sepal is the fourth floral whorl. This petal is corolla is the third floral whorl. These two calyx plus corolla, calyx for corolla, these are called as non-essential floral whorl or accessory floral whorl. Why these are called as like this? Because they don't take part directly in the process of reproduction. That needs to be remembered. They don't exist. They only just aid the process. They only just support the process or help the process, but they do not directly take part into the reproduction. Now, third one is what? Your androecium. So now this androecium is the third floral whorl. Its individual member is called as stamen. It is called as stamen. Okay. So here, that androecium and last one is your gynoecium. That androecium and gynoecium, these are the essential floral whorls. These are essential, means what? They do take part directly in the process of reproduction. They are very much important from the reproduction point of view. Therefore, they are called as essential floral whorl. So the androecium plus gynoecium. These are the essential floral whorls. Okay, now we'll see one by one. Third floral whorl is your androecium. So what is about androecium? Androecium is the third floral whorl. It is present inside to that of the corolla. Okay, so it is a male reproductive whorl. Kindly remember this. It is the male reproductive floral whorl. It consists of a stamen, individual member. Here I have drawn here. So this structure that I have drawn, this structure, entire structure is called as stamen. This whole structure is called as stamen, and this stamen consists of two different part. One filament like structure is there, which is called as filament, or a stalk like structure is there, which is called as filament, and to the tip of that filament you are having anther. Okay, so that again that filament and anther, they are connected by a specialized at a region that is called as connective. Then these anther lobes, there may be single anther lobe, which is called as monothecous, or that it may be having two anther lobe, it is called as diathecous. Okay, one anther lobe is having two pollen sacs, so two anther lobes will have four pollen sacs. So what are pollen sacs? That we'll discuss when we discuss androecium and stamen in detail. In that we'll going to learn this thing, that pollen sacs and formation of pollen grains in that pollen sac. Okay, so just for a time being, just remember that it is the male reproductive whorl. It is the third floral whorl. It consists of stamen, which is called as an individual member. That stamen is having two parts. First one is filament and second one is anther. Anther may have one floral whorl or two floral whorl. If it is having one, then it is called as monothecous. If it is having two, it is called as diathecous. One anther lobe is having two pollen sacs, so two anther lobes are having four pollen sacs. In that pollen sacs, the formation of pollen grains, that is microsporogenesis, the process of microsporogenesis takes place. Okay, so that is about the third floral whorl or floral leaves, group of floral leaves. And last one is your gynoecium. So all this structure, here it is rubbed. So this whole structure, okay, this structure is your gynoecium. Okay, gynoecium, again it is the fourth floral whorl. It is the innermost floral whorl. It is present innermost, means all the floral leaves are present periphery to it, but it is present centrally and it is the innermost. Second point to be remembered, that it is the female reproductive whorl. It is the female reproductive whorl. See, this stigma, this style and this ovary, that collectively forms a group of that forms the gynoecium. Means what? Here gynoecium consists of a carpel, or it is also called as a pistil, and that carpel or pistil consists of three parts. That consists of your ovary, then second thing is style, and third thing is stigma. So all these three parts constitute a carpel, and if it is a group of carpel, then it becomes the gynoecium. It becomes the gynoecium. If it is a group of carpel, it becomes gynoecium. So that carpel is consist of three different parts. First one is ovary. Inside ovary, you may find the ovules here. Okay, ovules. In that ovule, again embryo sac is get developed, which consists of female gamete, which upon fertilization will develop into the seed, and this entire ovary portion will again get developed into the fruit after fertilization. Then this style is present, which facilitates the entry of the pollen grain through the pollen tube, and at the apex it consists of a stigma, which is sometimes sticky or feathery, just for a modification. It is modified for reception of the pollen grains, and the germination of that pollen grain takes place here, and pollen tube formation again takes place here, which goes inside. That pollen grain consists of male gamete. Here inside that ovary, ovules are present. Inside ovule, embryo sac is present. Embryo sac consists of ovum. Ovum consists of a female gamete, means it is a female gamete, and pollen grain consists of male gamete. Their fusion takes place. Zygote is formed. Embryo is formed. First of all, zygote is formed. Then after cell division, embryo is formed. Then after all, seed is formed, and that entire ovary is developed into fruit. So these two, androecium and gynoecium, these two floral valves are called as essential floral valve, because they take part, directly take part in the process of reproduction. Okay, so this is all about the structure of a typical flower. In this, we learned about the flower. In first part, we learned about introduction, why there is a significance of the flower, what is the significance of the flower, why flower is important from our perspective, from plant perspective. Then we discussed the definition as a highly condensed and modified shoot of a limited growth and is specially designed for the sexual reproduction. Then we learned different parts of the flower. Basically, it consists of two different parts. First one is floral axis, second one is floral leaves. Floral axis consists again two parts, pedicel and thalamus. Pedicel is the stalk of the flower. It may have a tiny leaf like structure which is called as bract. If bract is present, bracteate. If bract is absent, ebracteate. Then thalamus is again of different types. Thalamus is the swollen tip of the flower, pedicel. That at the tip of the pedicel, swollen structure is present, that is called as thalamus. It is the base on which the floral leaves arranged. Then second is floral leaves. In that we learned four different types of floral leaves: calyx, corolla, androecium, gynoecium. Individual member of calyx is called as sepal. Individual member of corolla is called as petal. Individual member of androecium is called as stamen, and individual member of gynoecium is called as carpel. These two, calyx and corolla, they are outermost. Calyx is outermost, and inside that corolla is present. Both the floral valves are accessory floral valves or non-essential floral valves, because they only just help in the process of reproduction. These two floral valves, androecium and gynoecium, these are called as essential floral valves because they directly involved in the process of reproduction. I hope you have understood the structure of a typical flower. In next lecture, we will study different aspects of the flower. Till then, I thank you very much for your patient listening, and I hope you understood all this lecture. If you have any query, in the first slide I have given my email ID as well as mobile number. You can WhatsApp me or you can mail me your queries. For your patient listening, thank you again. Thank you very much.